And it will be County to kick off in this local derby. Your referee is Rob Whitten. This is Blue Square Bet Premier Action. We are almost underway, and the mass following of Newport County fans are in fantastic voice. It's going to be Christian Jolly there with Michael Flynn. County will kick off. The referee blows his whistle and we are underway, and the ball is immediately played to the far side where Connor gets her head to it. Towards the edge of the area, Griffiths goes for it, beaten in the air. Crow goes for it now, but it's a free kick to Newport County, and it's about 7 or 8 yards outside the edge of the penalty area. And this is Sandell coming across to take it to my right-hand side. Sandell then with the free kick. This is about 25 yards out. It's Sandell! And he whips it in, and the keeper takes it in the midriff. And he whipped that one in, Steve. But Musa wins it. Crow gets in and does well, Danny Crow. And feeds there Jolly. And Jolly robs one player. Robs in, shoots into the midriff of the goalkeeper. And again, Christian Jolly shows what a force he is and what a player he is. Great turn of pace there. And then gets the ball forward to Christian Jolly. He hooks the ball looking for Griffiths, but he doesn't find it. And in comes a snapshot there, which the keeper takes. And that's from Stefan Stam. Sandell is level with the edge of the penalty area. Throws the ball in. It's taken by Crow. In comes the cross to the far side. And ball is headed. But Pipe is in an advanced position. And Pipe is trying to win. But he's turned. He's turned beautifully. Gets it in. In comes the header. But the direction is lacking. But in comes the shot. It's touched. And it's gone for a goal kick. And James plays the ball to Watkins on that far side. Watkins looks, plays the ball inside, but then loses it. And Flynn plays the ball forward, looking for Reese Griffiths. Griffiths plays it into Minchell. Minchell plays a great-looking ball. Finds Christian Jolly on that far side. Goes in for the return pass. In comes the shot, and it's wide of goal. Oh, my goodness, that was a near opportunity there for Christian Jolly. At the ball with Crow. Crow takes the ball, back with Pipe. Pipe playing the ball into Christian Jolly, who's beaten in the air, but the ball ends up with Crow. Crow plays the ball inside. It's with Jolly going for shoots, and it's a brilliant save, and it's there, and County have, though it's disallowed. It's disallowed. It's disallowed. But Christian Jolly, a great shot there. The keeper saved it with a flying save, but the offside was up. The offside flag was up. Change in the defence for Hereford United. It's Joe Connor then. Plays the ball forward. Watkins gets the ball into midfield. And it ends up with Connor again. Ball is played forward. County got to be careful here. It's played in. In comes a shot, and it's wide of goal. And there was a real opportunity for Hereford United. And I think it was Klukas who's put the ball wide. And he was well placed and should have put his side ahead. Free kick is taken then by Pidgley. Ends up with Pipe, hooks the ball over his head. County look to get possession, but the ball is played the other way. And I tell you what, they're on a runner here, because Watkins is running onto it on that far side. He's outstripping Sandell, and the player, no, is not fouled. And the referee, in fact, has given a free kick to the home side, and it will be a booking. The linesman did not give it, and I think Sandell is going to be booked for this challenge. So this free kick is going to be whipped in from the far side. It's danger here for County. There's the yellow card. And this is about from the 5 yards from the corner of the penalty area on that far side. He had the chance 2 minutes ago. Glorious chance to put his side ahead, but he failed to do so. But he's got a chance to make amends here for Hereford United. A lot of pushing going in the box. It's whipped in. And there's danger here, but... In the shot is charged down, and County have got it clear. But it's a throw into the home side on that far side. The pressure is building. You sense something could be on here. A sharp turns, takes it, and the keeper there does well, Pidgley, and he holds it as the ball was bound for the top corner, and he unleashes it forward. And all of a sudden, County again coming under pressure. Neat play by Hereford United. County getting bodies in the way, plenty of bodies in the way, but they need to as a good ball comes in. And there's a chance. And the referee's given Hereford United a penalty. It's a penalty to Hereford United for a foul, and Whitten has given the penalty. And it was Jackson who was brought down. And in the 40th minute, it's a penalty. It was a little bit soft, but he went down and he was touched. and it's a penalty to Hereford United. It's Watkins against Pidgley. The referee blows his whistle. It's Watkins, and Pidgley saved it, and the referee's given a second penalty for handball. Would you believe it? He's given a second penalty for handball, and that's incredible decision. He's given handball. I can't see whether it's Minchell or it was Yakubu. I saw a hand go up, Steve, but it's absolutely extraordinary. He's given a second penalty within 30 seconds. Absolutely extraordinary. After Pidgley saved the first, then there was a hand went up. I think it could have been Yakubu. I'm not absolutely certain. Now it's a second penalty. Is it Watkins again? Yes, it is. They'll probably score this time. It's a second penalty. It's Pidgley. Can he save it again? It's penalties taken. And this time Hereford United have scored. And they are 1-0 up as Pidgley kicks the ball out. And the referee gave the penalty. And Hereford United have scored. And they've gone one goal up, and the village yokels have gone berserk. And it's O'Keefe with the penalty after Marley Watkins had one save. Free kick is whipped into the far side. Oh, and the keeper saves there at the far post. And I'm trying to see who it was, and I think it was Anthony there who got that. Byron Anthony. We've got three added minutes, and we've just started that as the ball is played to Crowe. Crowe plays it in. He's looking for Christian Jolly. Christian Jolly tries to play it over one of their players, but the ball is out into touch. But Christian Jolly looks a real live wire for County. It's Flynn with the throw-in. It's hurled deep into the box. It evades everyone, but it doesn't evade the Hereford defender. But the ball is played. It's with Flynn. Edge of the area. In it comes. It's charged down. County appeal for handball not given. And Hereford United managed to get the ball clear. Wrexham winning by 4-0. County with the throw-in. Ball is hurled in. Back out it comes. Bittner comes for it. Bittner saves it, going for a corner kick. And Hereford United will be very happy to slow things down in this last 90 seconds or so. Anyway, County got it all to do here. But it's Jolly on the far side, wriggling free. And he's got a corner kick. We have now played the 3 minute stoppage time, so really we're playing extra time in this first period. It's a corner kick, County a goal behind, in it comes. It's met at the far side, and it's half time. And there was a push in the box then, County appealing that they should have had a penalty, but the referee has blown his whistle for half time. It is Hereford United 1, Newport County AFC 0.
To give Hereford United that 1-0 lead at half time. I'm going to hand you over to Tim. They have just kicked off. Tim Thraves, here you are, sir.
Thank you very much, Steve. To my right hand side, the ball is hurled in. County have got to really stand firm in this opening period because they're going to come at County as Watkins whips one in, and it's beautifully taken, two handed by Pidgley. Over halfway. Minchell wins it, gets the ball forward, but it's won by Stamp, but it's played forward, and danger here for County, and in comes a snapshot, and the shot comes in from Jackson, and it's taken well by Pidgley, and really put Bittner under pressure as Pidgley plays it right-footed forward. It goes long again, misses everyone, it's headed by Jolly, but County appeal for handball. But Glucas turns and plays it forward to that far side. Yakubu has to head it out into touch. What's he going to do? Is he going to get the ball to this near side? Sandell still fights for it. And is fouled. And that is a free kick because O'Keefe fouls him. It's clean game. But it's only Sandell who's been booked for County this evening after 34 minutes. Flynn with the free kick. 6 yards in from the touchline, whips it in, right footed, it goes long, ball is headed to the far side, but it ends up in Bittner's grateful hands, and County really in the second half have not really created anything of note yet. And plays to Musa plays the ball forward to Glucas has time to play the ball back, and County are coming under pressure, they're backtracking a little bit, in comes the snapshot, and keeper has to go down Pidgley at his near post to collect and save it.
And that was the change that we did come up to. We also mentioned perhaps Robbie Wilmot may find a little bit of space in this game a little bit later on as well, Tim.
And County appeal, but the referee says no. County appealing for a penalty, not given, and I don't quite know what's happening here. And County feel they should have had. They're going to have a throw in, and they are appealing. They thought there was a foul in the box. Then should have had a penalty. It's a throw into County. It's taken quickly by Flynn to that far side. Donnelly gets it. It's headed by Minchell, and it's headed wide of goal. And it comes to nothing, but County had a claim, shout for a penalty, really could have been given. It's one in the air by James, forward it goes, Crowe goes for it, but County win it, and Minchell has won it. Minchell is fouled, down he goes, and County looking to take it quickly, are not allowed to by Mr. Whitten. Is this going to be a booking? I think it is. 15, that's... 60 minutes, and there's the booking. And it is O'Keefe. And it will be Sandell. He whips this in. It goes long to the far side. Oh, it's so nearly. It's Pipe. Oh, Yakubu has headed it over. It's taken a touch, but it's gone for. It's in fact offside against Yakubu, and it wouldn't have counted anyway. With Minchell, Crowe, and Jolly. Pipe is there. Donnelly is there. Flynn is there. It's into the box. Ball is headed and it's going to be headed out, but it's only as far as Donnelly. Donnelly, good ball, finds Sandell, whipped into the far side. It has to be headed. Ball is it's a free kick for a foul on the goalkeeper, which it was. Two or three players charged at the goalkeeper, and it was a free kick. Steve.
Yeah, I don't think we can argue with that. It was a vicious ball whipped in. It was curling. It was curling towards the goal. Bittner, I think, has got hit by two or three County players all trying to get on the end of that, and it's now just been shown a yellow card for his protest.
And Crowe is stood up on that far side, I'm pleased to say, but it's a throw into County. Flynn hurls the ball into the box, looks for Minchell, back out it comes. It's with Flynn, steadies himself, he crosses it, heads, oh, and it's headed wide by Minchell again, but... County are really getting some ball now. They're bringing some passes together and they're beginning to test the Hereford United defence. It's a corner kick to County. Taken quickly. It's with Donnelly. Back to Flynn. Flynn is going to whip this one in, which he does. And it's with Minchell. Minchell, and it's out, and it's another corner kick to County. And Donnelly will take it. And the pressure is being exerted by County, and they need to keep this going. We're 26 minutes into this second half. It's Donnelly with the corner kick. It's right-footed. It goes long. The keeper comes. The keeper punches it, and he did well there, Bittner. But County have won it again, and Donnelly goes forward, and he lays the ball to Sandell. County is showing us attacking force now, as Sandell takes the ball inside, and he plays the ball. It's 1-1! There's the equaliser! It's Minchell who's got it! At the far post, Minchell has met it, and County have their equaliser here at Edgar Street. It's Lee Minchell with the header. It's Hereford United 1, Newport County AFC 1, and they're going mad behind the goal, Steve. Minchell rose majestically at the far post. He climbed as high as the floodlit pylon, Steve. He was way above the defenders. Oh my goodness me, he was like a 7'8" attacker there. But Hereford United are going forward, and there's a free kick for a foul there on Jackson, and my goodness me. But they've got defending to do now, they really have. But see those fans go berserk behind the goal. In comes the free kick now, they've got to stand firm, and the referee's given a penalty for another handball. And it's handball to Hereford United. I didn't see who it was. Did you see?
Yeah, the ball was played in towards Pidgley. Pidgley managed to get a punch on it. It's dropped towards David Pipe, who's tried to swing at it rather than catch it with his foot. It's swung and hit his hand. No doubt, again, it was right in front of the referee as well. It was a definite penalty.
But it's going to be O'Keefe again, I think, with a third penalty for Hereford United. It's... going to be O'Keefe against Pidgley. And it's 2-1 to Hereford United. And they scored again. Hereford United have scored and they lead by 2-1. It's unbelievable, Steve, isn't it?
Well, again, Candy, they've done so much hard work in this last 20 minutes or so to get themselves back into this game.
And County still battling for every ball. They have got the ball through Anthony. Feeds Sandell. Sandell chips it forward and it finds Christian Jolly. Jolly plays it. It's piped, but it's hooked forward just a couple of yards off the line. And there was almost a chance for County. Free kick for a foul. And the pressure is starting to build with 11 and a half minutes left. Chip forward. Forward it goes. The keeper comes. The keeper collects and takes it quite easily. And the danger is over. But the ball is won by Graham. But Sandell with the ball in the air again. But Wilmot can't win it. But Anthony does in the air. Minchell wins it. Ball is with... And it's with Jolly. Jolly going forward. And the ball ends up with Sandell. Sandell takes it. Chips the ball. Minchell! 2-2! Minchell's done it again! It's Minchell who's got it again at the far post. And Minchell has equalised for County. What a cross and what a goal. It's Minchell 2. Hereford United 2.
Thank you very much, Tim. Yeah, I think it was Sandell that put in another fantastic cross. Oh, my word. It's picked out Minchell. Minchell has risen again. The jump was superb. The timing was excellent. It's gone in like a bullet. The keeper has got absolutely no chance. And that's it. County draw level. Hereford United 2. Newport County 2. Is there going to be more drama? Will there be a late winner, Tim?
Too little too late for them as the free kick is taken by Pidgley. He's launched it long. Yakubu, oh, it's so nearly ended up with Jolly. Back out it comes, but it's only as far as Donnelly, who's done so well since he's come on. It's now the ball is with Pipe. Pipe plays the ball inside. Oh, Jolly. Oh, and it's gone for a goal kick, but I tell you what, they nearly opened them up yet again there. There was no question about that. And County win it with Minchell in the air. Goes for the ball again. Heads it forward. Good ball by Minchell. Turns neatly. It's with Wilmot. Wilmot's going forward. The ball is played inside. And they so nearly created something, but they didn't. And it's with Sandell. And Sandell plays the ball forward. And there's danger. Oh, he's so nearly. The player went for the ball. He went for the ball. No, as far as it was concerned, Wilmot was entitled to go for that ball, which he did, and the referee should not book him. He had every entitlement to go for that ball.
This ref's just having a little word with Wilmot, asking him to go away now. So there's I don't think there's going to be a card or anything shown there, Tim.
47 minutes, 2 minutes of the five, but there'll be another 1 minute, so I reckon we've got another 4 minutes to go here. As the ball is launched, Anthony wins it in the air. Ball is hooked forward, and Wilmot wins it. And Jolly gets... holds the ball up beautifully, and Minchell plays it forward, and the ball is over the top, and is it there? It's there! County have got to win it! They've got to win the game! There is pandemonium here! It's 3-2! And they've won it! Jolly it was! It's 3-2, I think it's Jolly.
I think it was Wilmot, Tim.
Wilmot was it?
Yeah, again, it was a fantastic
Wilmot,
ball played through.
It's Wilmot.
I don't know who nipped that ball over the top, but it was a fantastic ball. Wilmot showed his place. The keeper's run out towards him. All Wilmot has done is just ding it over the top. It's gone about 6 or 7 feet up in the air. Keeper's got no chance. It's dropped just under the bar. Newport County now winning this game. Hereford United 2, Newport County 3. And you want to see the celebrations behind the goal.
And Jolly goes for it. But the ball comes forward. It's with Wilmot again. It's with Donnelly. Donnelly shoots and the keeper takes it down at the near post. I make the referee's already looking at his watch as Bittner takes it. Sandell. Ball is out, it's a corner kick, and the County fans are about to celebrate. The referee has put his whistle in his mouth. It is a corner kick. Sandell and Flynn, they will take it. And there's the whistle for the end of the game, and County have the 3 points. It has finished Hereford United 2, Newport County AFC 3.